So I'm loving the unified experience. You can see here, this is something else that is on the horizon, and that is the ability to actually have a Google Meet running inside a document. Now, who's ever had this problem? You've been on a Google Meet and you're working on a document with a colleague. For me, that's pretty much every day. And you know, you're either constantly switching between tabs, or you know, you forget that they're in a background tab and you're picking your nose and then all of a sudden they can see. Or maybe you've got, you know, a screen and you've got two tabs open and you're trying to kind of like, juggle the windows around. That's what I end up doing. When I'm traveling and on the road, I actually take a second device. I take my laptop and I take an iPad Pro just as a dedicated meeting device. And so this picture in picture here of being able to have your Meet inside your documents as you're talking, have it as a picture in picture, is just absolutely bloody epic. I can't wait for that, because I know I'm going to be using that pretty much every day. And my marketing manager, Angel, who's in the background helping produce this live video, is, I'm sure, frothing at that, because we will spend hours at a time sometimes working on things together, and it's going to make it very, very easy to work together. So Google's big idea here is all of your work now in one place. And so it's about consolidating the applications. Yes, they've brought out new logos and that kind of thing. Yes, they've given this a new name, but it's really about all of your work in one place. And what that means is Google are really focusing on a unified experience. It's going to be interesting how they do that in the browser, you know, with the Microsoft suite of tools, which I guess is the competitor to Google. You've got all different apps and you kind of go to different apps for different specific purposes. But Google being in the browser, consolidating things in workspaces that kind of, you know, gel together nicely, it's certainly quite interesting. The one thing that I'm kind of missing from the unified workspace right this second is being able to have cloud search, which is a feature of what was G Suite Business, soon to change. That cloud search functionality, I'd love to have that inside the Gmail so that I can search and find stuff in my Google Drive and open a document. Because right now, if I want to open something from Drive, I've either got to open a new tab to cloud search, or I've got to open a new tab into Google Drive. So I'd love to have a unified search right inside of Gmail. I think they are adding some operators inside of Gmail so you can find documents and stuff, but it's not always great. So I'd love to see them improve that. So we've talked about all your work in new place. There are now two families of business plans, or two families of Google Workspace plans. Now, there is a business family and an enterprise family. Many of our audience are small business owners, and I know a number of you who are watching the video currently live are small business owners. For you, the business plans are going to be the only ones that are relevant. The enterprise plans are for businesses that are over 300 users. So if you've got 300 users, you have to switch to an enterprise plan. More information on that soon. But there are also three tiers of enterprise plans with different options available with them. So the three business plans are Business Starter, Business Standard, and Business Plus. I've got the dollars here in Australian dollars, although they have changed in the last 24 hours by about a dollar each. And so they may be subject to change, just keep note on that. I believe those prices are including GST, but again, they may be subject to change, so just watch out for that. But Starter, Standard, and Business Plus, and now the three plans. Now, Starter is equivalent to what was G Suite Basic, and Standard is equivalent to what was G Suite Business. Plus is a new plan, and what was G Suite Enterprise, which a number of our customers have taken up, you will fit into one of the three enterprise plans. They're not public, so I'm not going to share all of the pricing for those, but I'm going to take you through a few of those details and what they actually mean. Now, the actual cutover for these new plans is January 15, 2021. So right now, you're going to stay on the current plan that you're on. It might be renamed or anything, but the actual changes in the features of the plans, and I believe the official changes in the pricing of the plans, is not until January 15, 2021. And if right now you have a commitment contract, so if you have a yearly contract and you've already paid for the year, or maybe you've got a multi-year deal, if you've got a discount from us and an agreement where you've signed up for a number of years, that will also extend until the end of that agreement. If you took an upgrade offer where you upgraded from basic to business or from basic to enterprise, and you've got a number of years left on that, those will all be honored. If you are on a flexible plan and you're just paying month to month, January 15 is when you're going to be cut over. And of course, anyone who is renewing after January 15 on an annual, on a commitment plan, on anything else, any other special deals from January 15 is when the new pricing and the new feature changes will come into effect. And there are definitely some important feature changes, which is why I'm going to take you through these. And you will see that there are some changes to some of the different plans there. So let's talk Business Starter. This is what was the G Suite Basic plan. Not much has really changed with this. It's all pretty straightforward. However, Google have dialed back the support. So where you would previously be able to get 24-hour support for this plan, it's now going to be 8 hours, 5 days support. Now, I can only assume that they're going to police it somehow based on the country that you're in. And I'm not really sure how that's going to work for business owners and businesses that have staff spread across different countries and different time zones. It seems like a little bit of an odd choice. I have no idea how it's going to be policed, but apparently they're dialing back the support. We'll see how that's actually implemented. What I do know is that Google obviously have 24-hour support because they have been providing it, but also they've got, you know, customers all over the world. There's over 6 million businesses subscribed to Google Workspace. And so it's going to be interesting how that happens. Number two, what is being added is some new meet tools to Business Starter. So there's a few very basic meet tools that are being added there. Things like, and I've got to be careful with this so I don't accidentally share the right one, the wrong ones. Live transcriptions, I think, are already there, but they are adding, I think, the ability to raise your hand, the ability to blur your background, but most of the best features are actually being saved for the next one up there. Okay, so that's Business Starter, equivalent to G Suite Basic. Not really much is changing there. Business Standard is the next one, which is equivalent to G Suite Business. Now, most customers that we have are already on G Suite Business because the phenomenal feature of shared drives. If you're not already using shared drives, or if you're a business that's doing any kind of sharing and file storage inside Google Drive, if you're not on at least what was Business and is now Business Standard, then you got rocks in your head because it's an absolutely excellent, excellent feature. And the number of things that Google are adding to what is now the standard plan is really quite exciting, especially since the price is not really changing on this. It's effectively staying the same. So Meet Recording, which was previously restricted only for enterprise plans, has been, and this is a complete surprise to us, has now been added to Business Standard. And I've got to say, this is most likely pressure because of Zoom being able to record things on, you know, any plan, even on a free plan, I think you can record meetings. And so you can now record inside Google Meet and have it automatically saved into your Google Drive on the Business Standard plan, which is pretty damn awesome. Next up, some of the best features of Google Meet that are about to be released, like breakout rooms, QA, and running polls. I've tested all of these features and they are freaking awesome. They are all being rolled out to the standard plan as well. So they are all gonna come very soon. So if right now you're still a Zoomer and you're paying for that, you'll be able to very soon ditch that. If there were, if you're wanting the breakout rooms or QA or it's the recording or whatever, these are coming too soon to the Business Standard plan, which is absolutely awesome. Well done, Google. Thank you. I've been saying this for a long time that the recording should have come to the business plan and now it has, which is awesome. Now, next one, bit of a downside. Google Vault has been removed. It is now exclusively on the Plus plan, which I think is a bit of a bummer because this is a pretty damn awesome tool. And it's absolutely critical for anyone in healthcare, financial services, legal or consulting, or for anyone who, you know, really cares about the compliance side of your business and making sure that if you ever get sued or you have a project that goes bad, that you can actually make sure you have a good backup of all of the communications. So that's a bit of a bummer that that's being removed. You can still purchase it on a per user basis. That's going to add up the costs. You may consider to bump up to the Plus plan instead rather than buying Vault manually. Next up, storage is changing. Unlimited storage is going away and Google are instead giving 2 terabytes of storage per user. Now, I'm kind of in two minds about this. It is a bit of a bummer that for many people who upgraded to what was the business plan to get access to unlimited storage, that's now no longer available. However, I will say there are not that many customers that I would say would use more than 2 terabytes of storage per user. And Google have done the smart thing and actually pulled that together. So if you've got 10 staff in your business, you get 20 terabytes of storage. Honestly, I think you're going to struggle to fill that. We have 30, 40 staff and we probably have 4 or 5 terabytes of storage. And that's mainly because we upload raw 4K videos from our studio recordings. And we've got all those sitting in Google Drive, as well as everything else in our business, backups from customers and all kinds of things. So I'd say you'll probably struggle to use all of that storage, but I believe there will still be options to upgrade your storage if you need additional storage on top of that. So anyway, that's the storage situation. And support is also being dialed back here. It's 24 hours a day, but only 5 days. Again, I don't know how that's going to work with the time zones. Fairly interesting, but that is what it is. Okay, finally is the Business Plus plan. And this one includes Google Vault, includes some pretty awesome advanced Google Meet transcription features. So it will only not only transcribe your Google meetings, but it will also do language translations live, which is just freaking awesome. Maybe you're presenting to someone who's based in a different country or a different language. You can have, I think it's about 200 to 250 people on a meet. That was previously reserved only for enterprise. So you can have massive teams joining Google Meets, and you've got that live real-time translation there, which is pretty damn awesome. And you know, apart from that, I don't think Plus like blows me out of the water with features there. I think you'd have to be a specific kind of business to want to take up these features. I also believe that Plus is a way of price positioning the business plan as the smartest plan, or what is now the standard plan, as the, you know, the most obvious choice. But there's some great features here on Plus if you do find that you need more. If you are in any kind of consulting, legal, any kind of business where you know, communication is absolutely vital for you to keep a copy of, you'd want to make sure you're on Plus so you can get access to Google Vault, because that is an amazingly useful and important tool.